Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA. On June 17th, NASA Administrator Charlie Bolden gave the keynote address at the Aviation 2016 conference in Washington. The speech, entitled Concept to Reality, Our Journey to Transforming Aviation, focused on NASA Aeronautics' New Aviation Horizons, a 10-year research plan based on the President's Fiscal Year 2017 budget request. The plan includes developing, manufacturing, and flight testing several experimental aircraft, or X-planes. During his address, Bolden also highlighted the agency's first X-plane designation in a decade. The X-57, nicknamed Maxwell, is an experimental airplane with propellers powered by 14 electric motors. The five-day conference also featured details on a set of roadmaps created by the agency to guide research in finding solutions for safe, efficient growth in global aviation operations, innovation in commercial supersonic aircraft and ultra-efficient commercial vehicles, transitioning to low-carbon propulsion, real-time system-wide safety assurance, and assured autonomy for aviation transformation. NASA held a news briefing on June 16th to provide the status of the Juno mission to Jupiter. After an almost five-year voyage, the Juno spacecraft is scheduled to arrive at our solar system's most massive planet on July 4th. It will be the first spacecraft to orbit the poles of Jupiter, circling the Jovian world about 37 times in 20 months. The mission is expected to provide new details about the planet's core, composition, and magnetic fields, as well as provide new clues about the origins of the solar system. Expedition 47 Commander Tim Cooper used the International Space Station's Canadarm2 to release the orbital ATK Cygnus cargo craft June 14th, just hours after it was detached from the station's Unity module. Cygnus is loaded with trash and other unneeded items that will burn up re-entering Earth's atmosphere. After its release, Cygnus was used to conduct a fire safety experiment and will release a group of nanosatellites. The spacecraft arrived at the ISS on March 26th with tons of experiments and supplies for the station crew. It's scheduled to deorbit on June 22nd. During a ceremony on June 17th aboard the International Space Station, Expedition 47 Commander Tim Cooper of NASA handed over the reins of the orbital outpost to NASA's Jeff Williams, who will serve as commander of Expedition 48. Cooper, Yuri Malenchenko of Roscosmos, and Tim Peake of ESA are scheduled to complete their 186-day mission with a June 18th landing in Kazakhstan. Williams and flight engineers Alexei Ovchinin and Oleg Skripochka of Roscosmos will remain on the station until early September. In conjunction with the United States of Women Summit, NASA hosted Engaging Women and Girls in STEM Through Data Science at the agency's headquarters in Washington on June 15th. The program included discussions and presentations on the role of data science at NASA, opportunities for women and girls in data science, and information about NASA initiatives that aim to engage women and girls in science, technology, engineering, and math through data science. And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on social media and visit www.nasa.gov/twan.